Welcome. Let's compare functional programming and object-oriented programming. First item is various functions. In functional programming, they are independent. Anywhere you may define a function, anywhere you may refer to a function and invoke it. But in object-oriented programming, they are strictly bound to an object instance or directly to a class scope. In Java 8, we are in between these two types. Okay, we have functional interfaces, and we may define functions independently, and we may refer to these functional interfaces independently, and we may invoke them. They seem totally independent to us, but in the background, these functions are again bound to some object instances, but we don't see it. So to be optimistic, we may say that functions are independent programming units inside Java 8. The second is value state. In functional programming, pure functional programming, value state is immutable, so you cannot change an attribute throughout the application. You can only copy a value, modify it, and return it. In object-oriented programming, as you know, objects are mutable. We can change the attributes so that all the references that is addressing to this object uses the modified values. In Java 8, we have some constructs to protect the objects from modifications. The third one is function chaining. In functional programming, we may chain the functions. In object-oriented programming, we cannot change the functions. But if they are in the same instance, in object instance, and they have some proper return values, you may chain them. In Java 8, again, we are in somewhere between them. We have lambda functions, and we may chain these lambda functions to construct bigger functions. The other thing is synchronization and multi-core support. It is great in functional programming because it applies all the functional programming elements. And in object-oriented programming, it is possible to synchronize and leverage the multi-core, but it is really a cumbersome because of the mutability. And in Java 8, it is so much easier than Java 7. In the next chapter, I will try to explain the core concepts of functional programming. See you then.